In this video, I want to show you how to change a locally managed Firebox to a cloud-managed Firebox. This video assumes that you already have had a look at the Firebox Migration to Cloud Management guide in the WatchGuard Help Center. This guide provides you details to plan your migration before changing the Firebox to be a cloud-managed Firebox. In addition, it is expected that the locally managed Firebox is actively connected to WatchGuard Cloud. So, are you ready? Okay. Let us get started and head over to WatchGuard Cloud. From the dashboard, go to Configure, then Devices. Here we can see all added devices on this account. To identify if a device is cloud or locally managed, just hover over the icon next to the device's name. Select the locally managed device, then scroll down to the bottom of the page to the area Cloud Management. Click on Change to Cloud Management and confirm again to continue. If, like in our example, you already have cloud-managed devices, you not only get the default option to create a new configuration, no, you can decide to copy a configuration from another cloud-managed Firebox to use as a starting point. This, however, is tied to limitations and requirements, such like device and license parity, but also unsupported configuration settings. More details to this are available in the Help Center. In our case, I will go back and choose the option Create a new configuration. Here you can edit the device name, choose the correct time zone to where the device is located at, and confirm this with Next. We are asked to set up the external interface 0, so adding basic settings of which the Firebox's primary external interface is currently configured with. So for IP address configuration, choose between static, DHCP and PPPoE, and the following fields will accordingly show you further fields and radio buttons to choose and fill out. We will use static in our example and enter the primary IP address, the default gateway, and the public DNS server. At this point, do not worry or run away from this video if your Firebox's external interface might not be on interface 0. I will show you later where you can change the interface. So, let us click Next. Here we need to set the password for the status and admin account. The passwords require a length in the shown range and must consist of at least one upper and one lowercase character, but also at least one number and one symbol. If by any chance your Firebox's status and admin password meet these requirements, you can continue to use them and enter these here. If not, you will need to use the new entered passwords to log into the Fireware web UI on the device. When done, click Next. This page explains to us that with a click on Next, the local status and admin credentials will be updated to the cloud-managed credentials. Also that the configuration changes to the Firebox through the WatchGuard System Manager and Policy Manager or the Fireware Web UI are not available anymore. Now, all the rest of the configuration will stay untouched on the Firebox. So, with a click on Next, you will see a message about undeployed changes on the bottom of the page. Important at this point is that as soon as you schedule the deployment, the local configuration will be replaced by the cloud configuration, so it is very important that you configure all needed areas before the first deployment is done. We see the overview of all configuration settings. Please excuse not being able to go through all of them, yet we will look at the most important areas, helping you to know where these are. As you remember, we only configured the external interface 0 and I promised you to show you how to change the external interface. A click on the Networks tile shows us the current two configured networks. For the external network, click on the three dots of the current active interface and select No Traffic. You now have the option to select the interface on which your external network is running on. In my example, however, I will stay on interface 0. For the internal network, I want to change the network to match my locally managed Firebox's network and keep the associated interfaces. On the tab DHCP settings, you would either need to change the address pool to match the configured network or, like in my example, disable DHCP. So let us head back and click on the DNS tile. Here we can see the previous added public DNS server, and on the tabs to the right we have the option to configure internal DNS server, so a DNS server for specific domain names, and the option to enable DNS watch for this configuration. In our example, we leave all as is and click on Cancel. Next, we look at the device settings, which again provides the option to change the name of the device, time zone, and in addition, to view the configured NTP service. Along with DNS and the time zone, this is important information to be correct. When incorrect, issues arise such as incorrect logs, report timestamps, certificate verifications, and so on. Nothing needs to be changed, so we click Cancel. The default firewall policies and security services already provide a good starting point. For firewall policies, let us take a quick glance at the outgoing policy, which allows the shown traffic types from any internal to any external and enabled security services. Further details to firewall policies are available in the video on Get Started with Firebox Policies, and details to the security services, please check into the WatchGuard Help Center. A bit further down in the device configuration page, we can see the area VPN, so where you are able to configure your branch office and mobile VPNs. At the bottom of the page, you see the option Import Configuration. This does not support the import of the complete configuration from a locally managed Firebox, but some areas can be selected to be imported. This is covered in the tutorial video on Import Configuration to WatchGuard Cloud. Just to let you know, when you click on the icon with a question mark, the Help Center will show you the information closest to the area where you're at in the WatchGuard Cloud UI. When you feel having completed the configuration and being ready to get deployed, click on Schedule Deployment at the bottom of the page. This gives us the option to schedule the deployment for a certain date and time, or, as in our example, deploy the changes now, and the Firebox downloads the new configuration. In summary, you have learned how to change a locally managed Firebox to become a cloud-managed Firebox. Since the Firebox cannot be locally and cloud-managed at the same time, you must build a new configuration in WatchGuard Cloud, but you have the option to import certain settings from your local Firebox configuration file to WatchGuard Cloud. The local configuration persists on the Firebox until the first deployment. If you're seeking for more information, please have a look at the other tutorial videos, but also check out the WatchGuard Help Center.